Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
What are we learning about monkeypox in terms of how it spreads and how dangerous it could be as this thing evolves?
Well, fortunately, the good thing is that it hasn't been very dangerous. There was one death reported in Europe and two children infected over there as well. In the United States, as you said, there's over 600 cases now. That's probably grossly overreported. But a couple disturbing things is that in one study reported last week that antibodies to the virus itself, the monkeypox virus, have been found going back in the United States to 2018. And another study in Belgium showed that in some frozen samples from a sexually transmitted disease clinic have found evidence of monkeypox going back a few years. So it's been around a lot longer than we thought.
Talk about the new variant of COVID-19. Is it the BA5 variant? How is it stack up against the others?
Yeah, BA5 is the new one. It's over 50% of all the cases now. This was reported from South Africa several months ago. BA4 and BA5 typically going together. They're accounting for about 70% of all the infection now. The problem with them is that prior infection and the vaccines don't have nearly as much impact on these. Now, the disease is still relatively mild. The disease isn't any worse. The hospitalization rate has only crept up a little bit. So we're not seeing, you know, a huge difference, but it's just spreading fast. It's just incredibly transmissible.
And Paxlovid is easier to get, but how do we know when we meet the threshold to need it?
Yeah, I mean, if you're eligible for Paxlovid, which right now requires you, anybody 12 and over, the younger kids have to be at least 40 kilos or 88 pounds. If you have any kind of medical or mental health problem, I mean, you're eligible to take it. And then, of course, people that are older are eligible too. And the big problem has been in getting the prescription. I mean, you have to get the doctor to get the prescription to call it in. I call in several of these a day. And, you know, I mean, doctors everywhere calling them in. And so you have to take, the earlier you take it, the better. And I think this move is very smart. I think that the pharmacist, you know, if the patient can document that they have the infection or have the test done at the pharmacy itself, I think this is a step forward in getting the drug out there. The AMA has come out against pharmacists distributing the drug, but I think, you know, we just have, it's a pandemic and people need to get this drug.
All right, Dr. Murphy still answers COVID-19 questions Tuesdays on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via Facebook message or email, and check out Dr. Murphy on the Explore Global Health podcast. Good to talk to you, doctor.
Thank you, doctor.
Have a great weekend.
You too.
You too.